Good morning to all of you. Today I am going to discuss on the topic types of communication. But before that, I want to ask from you people, in fact, and I want to remind you people mainly that in the previous class, what we have discussed. In the previous class, we have discussed about definition of communication, then the characteristics of communication and process of communication. As far as definition of communication is concerned, communication means sharing of information among two or more person. Now, sharing of information means both the person must have understood the same thing. Only then sharing of information is meaningful. Now, coming to the characteristics of communication, we have discussed it is unavoidable. It is a two-way process. It involves sender and receiver both. It could be verbal or non-verbal. It is a social process. It is a continuous process. It is a technical process. It is a universal process. And the last one, which is the important, most important fact, it is communication is successful when the receiver interprets the same meaning and sense as that intended by the sender. It means whatever the intention of sender regarding that sort of content which is being transferred from the sender side to the receiver, the same meaning and sense must be understood by the receiver also. If it is prevailing, only in that very case one can say communication is successful. Now, the next topic which we have discussed, in fact, that is process of communication. In the process of communication, we have drawn a figure, and in which there was sender, receiver, sender, encoder, message, decoder, and then receiver. When sender sends the message, he becomes sender, and when the receiver receives the message, he becomes receiver. On the same way, when receiver will send the message, means message will be flow from the side of receiver, then receiver sends the message, he becomes sender. Means receiver might be sender or receiver, or anyone might be sender or receiver, depends upon the nature of work, whether he is sending the information or whether he is receiving the information. If the person is sending the information, he becomes sender. If he is receiving the information, he becomes receiver. Now, the elements of process of communication, we have discussed sender, receiver, encoder, decoder, encoding, decoding, message, channel, noise, and feedback. These all points we have discussed in the previous class. That was a recap of the whole class, in fact. Now, today we are going to discuss the types of communication. It is the types of communication on the basis of method of communication. So, on the basis of method of communication, communication is bifurcated into two parts. One is verbal communication and other is non-verbal communication. Now, as far as verbal communication is concerned, it is of two types, oral and written. Now, before that, I want to discuss you will impact what is verbal and what is non-verbal communication. Verbal means use of word, means when communication takes place with the use of word, it is known as verbal communication. Means words will be used for the sake of communication. Now, words will be used for the communication, but it may be used in two ways. One will be oral and other will be written. When words are used or resembles or expressed in a written form, it is known as written communication. And when the same words are being uttered for the sake of communication, it is known as oral communication. Now, coming to the advantage of oral communication. The very first advantage is speed. Speed means whatever time I have consumed to recap the previous class, same time will not be used for the sake of written communication. More and more time will be consumed for the sake of written communication if we will communicate same sorts of content. Means same content will be expressed in a oral form in a less amount of time, and comparative with the written communication. So a speed of oral communication is quite more than that of written communication. Now the second point is, a speaker is able to get personal attention of the listener. It means when communication are occurring face to face, means I can watch receiver, listeners, and listener can watch me. In that very case, if I am sender, I will be the speaker. So I am able to get personal attention of one and all listener, whether they are attentive or not. Means their attention is towards the topic, towards the content or not, it will be understood by the facial expression of the listener. Easily one can get it in fact. Or when there will be some sorts of questionnaire, one can know about it. So a speaker can get this sort of advantage in the case of oral communication, more compared with the written. Next one is, it allows instantaneous feedback. Means receiver, when I will ask something, and or when a speaker will see towards the face of listener, instantly they would be able to know whether they are able to understand or not with the feedback. Now feedback is being resembled from their facial expression. Suppose I am not able to understand, in that very case I will resemble my face like this very way. Means ये भ्रुकुटी जो है वो तन जाएगी हमारी. सो दिस टाइप्स ऑफ फेशियल एक्सप्रेशन में अकर. और आई मे से लाइक दिस मीन्स माई हैंड, आई मे यूज माई हैंड फॉर द सेक ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग द थिंग्स विद आई एम एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. और आई कॉन्ट से आई मे नोट माई हेड इन फैक्ट. मीन्स बाय द बॉडी लैंग्वेज, बाय द फेशियल एक्सप्रेशन, वन कैन अंडरस्टैंड वेदर लिसनर्स और रिसीवर्स आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंटेंट और नॉट. द नेक्स्ट वन इज personal quality. Means the personal quality of a person, those who are going to deliver their message, plays a main role in the case of oral communication. Suppose your father is telling you something regarding to doing, for the sake of doing any work. Suppose your father is telling you to go and study. If the same matter is being told by your younger brother, how much you will pay attention? Just think about it. It means in oral communication, the personal quality of a person plays a big role for the sake of attention, for the sake of doing that sort of work, whatever is being provided in fact. Now the next point is confidentiality. Confidentiality means secrecy. It means in the case of oral communication, one can maintain secrecy at the highest level. Suppose I want to say something to someone, just I will whisper the words or content in the ears of that very person. No other person would be able to understand or know what was discussed. But in the case of written, if the same content I will provide them in the written form, and if someone will check, that will resemble. Suppose we are going to take the example of examination hall impact. Suppose someone is going to ask something from his friend, and the person, those teachers or faculty, those who are guiding the room, guiding the students, so they would, if they are far from that person and just they are going there and asking why, what you are discussing. So it might be possible he may say, sir, nothing sir, I have just asked about the time, what is the time. Now just think, any person will not be able to know what was discussed. But if the same thing will be done in a written form and he will put that things in a pocket, that after checking that will be revealed. It means in the case of written communication, confidentiality will not be maintained up to that level as it will be maintained in the case of oral communication. Now coming to the next point, point number 6, supplemented by the non-verbal cue. Whatever I am doing, I am just communicating to you people in an oral manner in fact. So in an oral communication, I can use the non-verbal clues, means my body language, just head movement, eye movement, hand movement, gesture, pose, entire things will be used for the sake of communication. Means whatever I am going to say, to make that sort of content emphatic, I use the non-verbal communication. Means in the case of oral communication, non-verbal clues are used for the sake of making the content emphatic. Next, saves time and money. Obvious, as the speed in the case of oral communication is more compared with the written one, that's why one can deliver the content in a very less amount of time. So time will be saved, and as we all know, there is a proverb, time is money. So we can say time as well as money will be saved by this way, just by using an oral communication. Next, suitable for emergency. Obviously, suppose in an organization you are going elsewhere, you can tell your subordinate that I am going there, now you can take charge, whatever work I was doing you have to do. Now suppose the inspection, if there is there will be an inspection, in that very case what your subordinate tell to the inspector, those who will check, just he will say, sir has given me an oral order. So there was no black and white, in the form of black and white, then in that very case the inspector will not agree. Now if you will be at that instant, and if you are going elsewhere and you don't have any sort of time, in fact, in that very case definitely you will use oral communication, but it may create some problem in the next future. One must demand, or one will demand in a written form. In that very case, it will consume more and more time compared with the oral communication. So in the case of emergency, only oral communications are good because it consumes less time. Now the next one is lesser formal. In the case of oral communication, formality are less. Suppose I am telling you about an application which you are going to write, and you have written, and now you are going to produce it to your principal, your headmaster or class teacher. Now if the class teacher asks what are the matter, in fact, then what you will say, just you will say in a nutshell what is the content in the letter. It means you will say only about the subject on which the matter was discussed, or about which the matter was discussed, but you will not say from the very beginning. From the very beginning means to the principal. Suppose I am going to write to our college head, then in that case I can say to the registrar, Alminster College of Business Management, so and so. So in this way I will not narrate the content, just I have to say only about the main theme about which the contents are being discussed. So in the case of oral communication, we will say the main point, main theme in fact, so it becomes less formal in oral communication, while in the case of written, I have to maintain the format, whatever we are going to discuss. So entire format will be used for the sake of written communication. Now the next point is group communication is easily possible. In a very, if people are in a good amount, in that very case, easily one can communicate in making a group. So group communication can be easily possible in the case of oral communication, while in the case of written communication, it will take a lot of time. But now the next one is exemptions of error. It is one of the most important, which we have to understand. Impact means in the case of oral communication, we commit a lot of mistake compared with the written one, because we have less amount of time to just inculcate our mind, to switch over one sentence to other sentence, one words to the other words. Means there is less amount of time, means reaction time of our mind to switch from one words to other word, or from one sentence to another sentence, that is quite much less compared with the written communication. So in an oral communication, we commit more mistake compared with the written one. As our audience are watching and they are able to know, they know that things are being communicated in an oral manner. So the time, that is reaction time, is less. That's why the error might be more. So they can think about it. So there is an exemption of error in the case of oral communication. While in the case of written communication, you have more and more time to think, and then you can write whatever you want to write. So in that very case, you have to commit less mistake, and the same expectation will be from the side of receivers also. So in that very case, just you can think that in oral communication there will be an exemption of error. So today what we have discussed about the, on the basis of method of communication, there are two types of communication. One is verbal and other is non-verbal. In verbal communication, we use words only. So now words can be expressed into form, oral or written. In an oral communication, we just utter that sort of word, whatever we have to communicate. Or in the case of written communication, we will write those sort of content. Now advantages are speed. Second is speaker is not able to, speaker is able to get personal attention from listener. Next one is it allows instantaneous feedback. Next, personal quality in the oral communication plays a bigger role. Next, confidentiality. Next, supplemented by non-verbal clue. Next, same time and money. Next, suitable for emergency. Next one is lesser formal. And the next is group communication is possible. And last but not the least one is exemption of error. In the next class, we will discuss about the disadvantage of oral communication as well as written communication, their advantages and their disadvantages. Thank you.